There are several ways to connect speaker wire. You can use bare wire or you can use connectors. Which is better? In this video, we are going to help you make sense of speaker wire connectors. First, we will discuss the speaker connectors found on amplifier outputs and on speaker inputs. There are two main types of wire terminals, spring clips and binding posts. Spring clips are typically found on entry-level gear, such as inexpensive stereo or home theater receivers. They're easy to use. You simply push the tab in, insert the bare wire, and release the tab so it clamps down on the wire. Spring clips are not compatible with most varieties of speaker wire connectors, so bare wire is usually the best way to connect your wire to spring clip terminals. The second type of speaker wire terminals are called binding posts, sometimes referred to as five-way binding posts. More on the five ways in a minute. Instead of a spring clip, binding posts have a metal threaded post with a hole in the side for the speaker wire and a large nut that threads on and clamps down on the wire, holding it tight in the post. You can use several different styles of speaker wire connectors on a binding post, and it's generally accepted that these are a step up from spring clips because of how much better the connection is between the wire and the metal post. All speaker wire and terminals have a positive and a negative connection. These are usually obvious from their red and black colors or positive and negative markings next to each connector. As for the speaker wire, one side will have writing on it. Sometimes it even has plus signs indicating positive, while the negative has no writing on it at all. As long as you connect the speaker wire for each speaker in your system the same way, your speakers will be in phase and all will be fine. First, we'll cover the types of connectors that are commonly used, starting with no connectors at all, bare wire. Just about every amplifier and speaker has connectors, spring clips, or binding posts that will accept bare wire. All you need to do is strip the insulation off the end of the speaker wires. Half an inch or less will do. Twist the loose strands of copper wire together into a tight spiral, then insert the twisted bare wire into the spring clip hole and release, or into the hole on the side of the binding post and tighten down the nut. One of the benefits of using bare wire is that it's the cheapest and most basic universal method of connecting speaker wire. Speaker wire that comes with pre-attached connectors eliminates all the potential issues of dealing with bulk wire. It's pre-cut to length. You won't have to attach connectors to the wire or worry about loose strands of copper or corrosion in the wire itself. Check out the Crutchfield speaker wire with connectors for a great value on pre-terminated speaker wire. There are several types of connectors you can choose to use with your speaker wire. Five-way binding posts are called that because of the five common ways to connect speaker wire to them: bare wire, pin connectors, spade connectors, banana plugs, and dual banana plugs. We'll cover each one, starting with the most popular by far, banana plugs. The main benefit of banana plugs is that they can be attached to the terminals without any tools or loosening and tightening of the nut on the binding post. You simply stick them into the holes on the end of the binding post. That's it. They hold themselves solidly in place with metal tension and give you great conductivity. And when you need to disconnect them, you just pull hard on the connector itself and it comes right out. They are too big to fit into spring clips. If you look at your speaker wire terminal and you don't see openings at the end of your binding post, don't be alarmed. This is common, especially on speakers. Look closer and you'll likely find that there's a plastic plug in the end of the binding post. Once you remove that plug, you should be able to connect your banana plug no problem. And yes, we've had many customers call into our tech support department about this. And boy, are they happy when we show them how to remove the plastic plug and get their wire connected. If you can't pry it out with your fingernails, just grab a small flat blade screwdriver and that should do the trick. Here's one more tech tip for you. Often when you try to insert a banana plug for the first time, it doesn't feel like it will go in unless you push unreasonably hard. This is normal. There's two things you can do about this. One, push real hard with solid, even pressure so it goes straight in. You might have to push harder than you realize, but it will go in. Also, you can take a pair of pliers and gently squeeze the metal leaves just a little bit so it goes in a tad easier. Crutchfield Tech Support recommends banana plugs as the best way to connect speaker wires, since they provide a strong connection with fewer potential issues than bare wire presents. Dual banana plugs aren't nearly as common as single banana plugs, mainly because they require positive and negative binding posts to be a standard distance apart. And well, simply put, not all speakers and amplifiers adhere to a standard for that spacing. If yours happens to match up though, dual banana plugs are even easier to connect than single banana plugs. Spade connectors are flat, forked, and kind of look like a spade or a shovel. Spade connectors are not compatible with spring clip terminals, but can easily be inserted between the base and the nut of a binding post. Then you tighten the nut to hold the spade connector solid. Pin connectors are the last of the five ways. Most pin connectors are solid metal, thinner than banana plugs, and are designed to be inserted into the hole on the side of the binding post instead of bare wire. Their rigidity makes this process much easier. Some pins are made of soft braided brass so they can compress and make a really good connection. Pin connectors are nicer than using bare wire because they clean up all those loose copper strands. However, most people prefer the convenience of banana plugs or spade connectors. Many speakers have two sets of binding posts connected together with a solid piece of metal or wire called a jumper. These speakers are designed with the ability to be bi-amped or bi-wired. Bi-amping is when you use two amplifier channels to power one speaker enclosure. The top set of speaker wires feed the high-frequency section of your speaker, the tweeters and mid-range drivers, while the bottom set of connectors feed the low-frequency drivers, the woofers. Powering each of these separately gives you more overall output and better clarity and accuracy. You'll need two sets of speaker wires to fully bi-amp your speakers, and either two separate amplifiers or two amplifier channels from a receiver or amplifier. Bi-wiring is when you use one amplifier channel to power the speaker enclosure, but on the speaker end of the speaker wire, you connect separately to the top and bottom set of inputs. This gives the top or the high-frequency drivers and the low-frequency woofers their own input, allowing the crossover to be more effective at delivering the high frequencies to the tweeters and mid-range and the bass to the woofers. Both bi-amping and bi-wiring requires you to remove the jumpers from the two sets of connectors on the speaker wire terminal. If you are not bi-amping or bi-wiring, make sure to leave those jumpers in place so that both sets of terminals get fed input from your single set of speaker wires. Also, some large speakers have an extra set of speaker wire inputs for height speakers, usually for Dolby Atmos surround sound. These inputs are for built-in or optional speaker toppers that have speakers aimed at the ceiling for height effects in movies. Make sure to connect your main speaker wires to your speaker's main inputs and the height channel wires to the height input terminals. I hope that helps you understand what it takes to get your amp connected to your speakers. If you have any questions about this or anything else, reach out to us here at Crutchfield. We are happy to help. And thanks for watching.